Hi you guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Devyani and in today's video I'm gonna share with you 7 things you have to do when you land in the UK. So when I got here in London, I had no idea how to register with the GP, how to get your rail card, SIM card, NI number and all of that. So this video has like a detailed step-by-step guide on where to apply, how to apply, the waiting time, the documents needed and all of that. So if you find this video helpful, do give this video a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm adding all the links required in the description box below, so do check them out as well. And there are some offers you can avail. So without further ado, let's just get into the video. I'm going to talk about how to get your SIM card, NI number, bank account, GP registration, rail card, Oyster card, BRP and student card. So when it comes to SIM cards, you have a lot of options. The VFS Global office in India provides you with a Lebara SIM card. As you can see, it's a bit expensive, £5 for 2GB. You have other providers like O2, there is Voxy, GiftGaff, and there are multiple offers for it. But I personally recommend you Voxy. So I have been using Voxy since I came to the UK. So for £10, you get 8GB. But the best part is, in this 8GB, you get endless social media for £10. So you can use Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp for free. So that means your data is not charged. So I have been using this pack for the past 15 days and only 4GB has been used because Instagram and Facebook, the data is not utilized. I really, really like it. So I've added the link in the description box below of how you can get Voxy. So if you click on it, you can see that you can avail a £20 Amazon gift card because of it. So just go on the link, click on the link below and select whichever, you know, pack you want. The 8GB one, the 12, the 15 or 45. There are multiple options. So go down and click order SIM card and select whatever plan you want to go. For example, the £10 one and say order SIM card. Then put in your first name, last name, your email address and your postcode in UK. And 2-3 days later, this is delivered to your house. Your SIM card is attached there. And this one automatically renews every month, so you don't need to worry about it. So as an international student, to do a part-time job, an internship or a full-time job, you need an NI number, which is a national insurance number. So for that, simply type NI number on Google and follow the instructions. So here, am I looking for a job in UK? Yes, I'm looking for the work. I put in my full name. So right now I'm faking some details because obviously I don't want to reveal them online. Some details are true, of course. So female, so my date of birth, which is 24th of September 1998. My nationality is an Indian. Do I have a passport? This is a very random passport number I'm putting, but of course you have to put in your real passport number and your BRP number. This was very random. I haven't lived in UK all my life. I came to UK 9th of September 2021. What's your address, which I'm not going to reveal. So just fill in all the details, okay? And do accept and send. So as you can see here, the first point, this is your application reference number. So until you get your NI number, this is the number you have to use while applying. Then make a black and white photocopy of this page and passport that includes your photograph and your signature. And make a photocopy of the following documents. So print this form and fill in the details using a black pen and post it to the address given below. And within 30 days to like 4 months-ish, you will receive your NI number, which you're going to use while applying for jobs. Okay, so take this advice very seriously. Start applying for your bank account as soon as you land in the UK because I made that mistake. I wanted to apply for a Barclays student account and I applied sometime in October and I got an appointment for December. So I could not apply for Barclays. So for Barclays, HSBC, you need to apply through your phone, which has a mobile app. But for Lloyds, you can do it online. So I have applied for a Lloyds account and I haven't received my card yet. It's like November now. Like I really need to buck up. So basically just go on the Lloyds website. It's pretty easy. Follow the instructions which are on the screen. So every bank account needs different kind of documents. For at least for Lloyds, I needed my BRP card and a confirmation of studies letter, which you can find in your student's record or you can get it from university. So I had submitted those two documents and now I'm just waiting for my bank account, but that's pretty easy. So until you get your official bank account, you can go for options like Monzo or Revolut. So you can download the apps through your phone using Android or iOS. So basically, you just apply for the card and they just deliver it online. So all the verification, all the checks are done via the app and it's pretty easy. So I'm adding the links in the description box below. So if you want to check it out, do that. And also, if you want to earn some pounds, download the Revolut app, verify it, then see the instructions which are given here. Like, order the physical Revolut card and make three separate purchases for £5 each. And these simple steps, and both of us can earn £50 each. So just do it. So for GP registration, you have two options. You can either register yourself with your university or do it on your own. So because my university is a bit far away, I decided to go on my own. So for that, you can do like, okay, GP near me or GP in your area. For example, you stay in Greenwich. So you can say GP in Greenwich or GP in South Bank and things like that. So for this, I have chosen, like, for example, let's take the option like GP in Holborn. So as you can see, there are multiple options you can choose online. So let's just go for the first one and open the website. It's pretty direct. So you can like overall layout is pretty similar for any GP site. So you just go here, then just register as a new patient and put in all your details. So basically, after you register, you will get a confirmation, a call, or probably an email to confirm that you have been registered with your GP. And after that, after I think 1 week or so, you will receive your NHS number, which is delivered at home via post. So it's pretty easy to do. And you'll be assigned to your GP. So if you need anything, if you're not feeling well, you can reach out to your GP anytime you want. Also, the NHS website has a lot of information if you have like the common cold or cough and symptoms like that. For more extreme things, you can contact your GP, get a prescription, go to the pharmacy, and get the required medicines. Overall, it's pretty easy. Just go online and register yourself as a new patient, and soon you'll be registered. As a student, you can avail the 16 to 25 rail card. So most people go to railcard.uk. So basically, a railcard is a card which you can use to travel intercity. So as a student, you can get discounts. So for £30 a year, you get subsidized prices. So if you go on this website, this actually does not work. This is just an example of what doesn't work. So if you go here, put in like your title, for example, like Mr. La 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 Archit Rao. I'm just putting some random details. And I go on passport. So if you can see here, it's different. Like if you see our Indian passport, the details do not match. Like we don't have an option of putting like 10 characters, 3 characters, very different. So what I recommend and what I have used is Trainline. So it's an app as well. You can download it on iOS or on Android phones. So you go there and say buy rail cards. You get 16 to 35. You can buy a 3-year rail card for £70 or just 1-year thing. I got the 1-year thing personally. So go and put in your name. I don't know who Archit Rao is. I don't know, just like a random name though. And I said continue, and then I can just put in my passport, go on passport and put the details which is below, like at the end of the passport. And then you can just simply pay £30 online and you just have the card. So if you can see, for example, if you go to London or to Leeds, and I select a random timing, if you can see like the prices, it's like £61, £59, which is quite expensive for one way trip. So if, say like 6,100 to 59. But if you go, like if you have a rail card, you just go select 16 to 25 rail card. And if you see and compare the prices, it has become very less. So if you can see, like it's £38 here. If I scroll a bit down, 30, £35, 29. So it goes as low as 29. So compared to like £60, of course, if you're paying 29, you're gonna save up a lot. So this is very specifically for students who are living in London. So to travel in London via tube or bus, you need to get an Oyster card. So what you have to do for that is go to any station. So it could be any station, Holborn Station, Stratford Station, anywhere you want, and there are many machines there. So go to any machine, say, okay, get a new card. So you want one card, okay. So it's processing. So every Oyster card is for £5. So you can load up any amount you want. So for example, I want to put £20. So £20 is the credit and £5 is for the Oyster card, which you can get a refund for when you return it. So when you pay up, an Oyster card is dispensed. So I already had an Oyster card, so I did not buy a new one. But just when you touch it there, you can add credit. So I right now have like £2.65. So I added £5, then it's gonna be like £7.65. On the other hand, if all students have another Oyster card, which is the student card. So with the student card, you have special discounts. Like you can get the seasonal ticket. Okay, so with the seasonal ticket, which is for like a month or 7 days, you can choose like, okay, you're traveling from, for example, zone 1 or zone 3 to zone 5, whatever. You select the date. So I've taken a 7-day travel card. And with these £45, I can travel as many times as I want. So you can get a student card. Just go online. I've added the link in the description box below. You have to create a new web account because I already have an account. I cannot make a new one, but you can see like you can just apply, just say apply for a new card, follow the steps and it will be delivered via post. So within 28 days after you land in the UK, you have to go and collect your BRP. So where to collect your BRP totally depends on your application form which you had filled while applying for the visa, the VFS global one. So if you put, you can put your address as the postal address near your house or your university address. So for us, we had to put in the university address, but this year King's College London mailed us the BRP and the student ID. So for some people it took like 2 weeks, for some people it has been a month and it hasn't arrived. You know, it totally depends on which university. Luckily for everyone in King's, we have received our BRP and our student IDs, but for many other universities, they still haven't received it. So this BRP is like one of the most important documents you can have. You have to care for it like your baby. If you're going to collect it from the post office near you, you need to carry some identification proof like your passport, and you can just go and simply collect it, and that's pretty much it. So this is very important because without your BRP, you cannot apply for a bank account. So just make sure you have it. With your student ID, you can get some really great discounts. So just go to any store. Like if you go shopping, for example, to H&M, just with your student card, you can get like a 20% discount. I hope this video was very helpful. If you have any other questions, do comment below. I will reply to all of you and have a good day. Bye.